Welcome to Plaid for Women TV, your go-to resource for the business of life. Whether the CEO of your home or your own business, women struggle with the same challenges. At Plaid TV, we discuss real-life issues affecting real women and offer solutions to help you achieve your goals, get connected, and be heard. Together, we will change the world. Let's do this. No mean girls allowed.
Hey everybody, welcome to Plaid for Women Television. I'm Siobhan Palmer. Today we're going to be talking about women and relationships. We've got a great show called The Business of Love. I'm absolutely delighted to introduce my guest, Mr. Michael Bloomberg, the Romance CEO. Michael, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me.
Before we get into this first segment called The Power of Connection, I am very fascinated how you even got into this industry. So why don't you share a little bit about your background with our audience?
Well, first of all, I'm from Fort Worth. Went to UTA for undergrad, went to TCU for graduate school. And then about 10 years ago, I created the niche of marriage proposal consulting. What that is I work with clients all over the world, helping them create their dream marriage proposal. And those take place all over the world. Since doing that, that led into working with couples and really helping couples reconnect. But I do it in a really unique way. And that's taking them back to when they first met, which is date night.
Okay. So let me ask you this. Why did you, were you the go-to person years ago in your family with your friends? What made you the ideal proposal guy?
Well, that is true. Basically what happened was I always was the go-to guy. If it was an anniversary, a birthday, some fun event, a first date, people would call me, what do I wear? What do I do? What do I buy? If it was a birthday or anniversary. And that's part of the equation. The other equation is I actually helped a friend of mine propose. And that led into me going, wow, how cool would this be to do all over the globe?
That's awesome. I understand that your date nightology workshop is one of your signature events. So why don't you walk us through just what that is?
Absolutely. So date nightology, it really is exactly what it says. It's using date night to help couples reconnect. But more importantly, moving forward, it helps them stay connected.
Now, I understand that one of your primary audiences is military families. Is this also offered to civilians as well?
Absolutely. It's offered to both. And it really works well with both. Because I figured if it works well with deployed military people, it's really going to work with couples who see each other all the time.
So let's talk about specific issues that military couples have, like reuniting, and some of the issues you address during this workshop.
Well, sure. Well, I mean, some of the issues, obviously, is them just being apart. And anytime you're apart, that causes problems. Yeah. Then you have the stress of worrying about somebody. Mm-hmm. Then you have the stress of the roles of the person who stays here takes on both roles of the parent. And the person who is gone and deployed, they pretty much have one mission, and that's to be a soldier. Mm-hmm. So that's where I think the disconnect happens. And then after the deployment, you bring them back. So what date nightology does is it helps them reconnect.
Okay. So that you actually do this like in a workshop environment where you have multiple couples in a setting like this. Do you find that particularly with the military vets that they're kind of reticent to open up and share these challenges among their, you know, military buddies? Or do you feel like you really get similar feedback from a lot of these mm-hmm. guys or gals?
Because we don't talk about anything that happened while they were deployed, I think it's a really safe environment, particularly because everyone remembers when they first met, what their first date was, or when their first kiss was. And we start with that. And what that does is it gets them in a really safe place to be able to share, and not only with their significant other, but really in a room full of their peers.
Could you give me some examples or some of the stories that some of the vet families have shared with you relative to those experiences?
Well, there's one that the family, they were from Texas, I believe it was Fort Hood, and he got deployed to Korea. Mm-hmm. And so they were gone for, I think it was either 9 months to a year. And what they did after going to this workshop is they ended up having date night, but they did it virtually. He also ended up writing letters to her. They sent each other gifts, but they did it on a regular basis so that they knew on a certain day they were going to get that, or they would Skype and at that certain time. So it was a date, but they were thousands of miles away.
But it kept that connection in a real sense.
Mm-hmm. And the other thing, I think it's the gift that keeps on giving, because there's many couples, even 4 and 5 years later, they contact me and say, hey, guess what we did on date night? And it could just be nothing to most people, but to them, they want to brag about it. It's almost like a kid that wants approval from their father. Hey, guess what we did? And so I'm still hearing 3, 4, and 5 years later from people that go through the workshop about how they're planning date night or how they did a fun weekend away or something that's really maybe small to some people, but it was really fun for them.
Significant for them.
Absolutely.
Another thing I'm fascinated is you start off these day-long workshops by having everybody create a mission statement. Mm-hmm. So why don't you take us through that?
Well, the obvious reason is that they are military, so everybody knows that military has a mission. But what doesn't happen is couples often don't have a mission as a couple. They get married, they have kids, they have a job, they go to work, they come home. It becomes this kind of routine life. Right. But what is their real mission? And does that mission change? So what happens is we use a template and they fill it in. And then we get encourage them to create their own. And sometimes it's really neat because they'll print it out on a really cool piece of paper. And then we have them frame it. So they're constantly reminded. It stays on people's dressers or it might be on the kitchen counter.
And like you said, it resonates with people in the military that have a specific mission to abide by. Do you sometimes involve kids in developing like a family mission statement, or is it really just between the couple?
I think that a family could have a mission. With this date nightology workshop, we just focus on the couple.
Yeah, okay, great. Well, in the next segment, we're going to be talking about specifics on how to create a very cool date night for not only military families, but civilians. So we will address that in segment two. But thank you so much. Fascinating information.
Thank you.
This is Siobhan Palmer with Plan for Women Television, segment one in the business of love. We'll see you on the other side.
Thanks for watching Plaid TV. See you next time.